Hey everyone, Staci, Wallace here, and I'm very excited about sharing today's blog with you. 7 time management hacks that you must know. Now, it doesn't matter if you are a CEO, entrepreneur, home-based business owner, stay-at-home mom, homeschool mom, whatever you're doing in your life, you've got to know these 7 time management hacks. They will revolutionize your life. Over the course of the last 10 years, I have been blessed to be working with some top executives, CEOs, entrepreneurs, crazy serial entrepreneurs, folks who have massive organizations in the direct sales business. And what I have found is the common thread between everyone who is a top achiever, 7-8-figure income earner, they know these time management hacks and they apply them every single day. Now, recently we did a Facebook Live on this. I ran through in 15 minutes really fast. I encourage you guys, follow me on Facebook on my official Staci Wallace official page. It's facebook.com/StaciWallaceOfficial. Now that's where we're posting our Facebook Lives. You can get these in little bite-sized morsels, 15 minutes every Sunday. Every Wednesday, we're doing what's called Warrior DNA. And it's teaching you the DNA of the best warriors, top executives, people who live not only with a passion to be able to build massive businesses, but also who live with a passion to do good at life. See, we've seen a lot of people who are really good at making money, but they are horrible at doing life. Their marriages are falling apart. They've got issues with their children. Their health is falling apart. We want to make sure that as we train you and equip you with unique marketing strategies, that we're also helping you live a great life. So Warrior DNA, that's what that's all about. Now today, I'm going to give you a sneak peek into something called our Shift Happens Life Mastery Course. Again, we've been working on this for the past 10 years. We've been doing leadership summits every single year, bringing in 50 top executives, leaders, entrepreneurs. We do a ropes course. It's a full immersion, 3-day experience where we're coaching them to take their business, their life, their marriage, faith, family, finance, fitness to a whole nother level. Now, the information that we've gathered out of these summits is pretty extraordinary, and we've been compiling that data and putting together a life mastery course that I believe is going to revolutionize your business, your marriage, your life. It comes equipped with so much, but we're not ready to release it just yet. In fact, the manuscript is written, we're ready to start shooting videos, but I want to get more information from you. And so what we're going to be doing over the blog and the Warrior DNA is looking for your comments. So at the end of this video, I just encourage you to leave your comments below. Did you like it? Did it help you? If it did, of course, share it. Make sure you're posting it on Facebook, tweet about it. But more importantly, we're looking for feedback. We want to know, do these tips help you? And if they do, we want to make sure that we're putting the most extensive, the best of the best resources into our Life Mastery Course, which will come out later this year in June. So we want to encourage you to give us your feedback, give us your comments. Let's jump on into it. 7 time management hacks that everyone should know. We're going to break it down. Here we go. Number 1 is eat your peas first. It probably sounds crazy, right? What does that have to do? Eat your peas first. When I was a little girl, I absolutely hated peas. I loved macaroni and cheese. I loved peanut butter and jelly, all the things that are really not great for you. I loved ramen noodles, but I didn't want to eat my peas. So my mom and dad were great leaders, and I was stubborn. I'm sure you can't believe that. Warrior queen, who's stubborn, imagine that. I was stubborn, I didn't want to eat my peas, so they would tell me to eat my peas, and I wouldn't. So they said, okay, well, you're just gonna sit at the table until you finish your peas. And they would make me literally sit there. I sat there for 2 hours, just the peas are cold, it's the only thing on my plate, and everybody else is going about life, and I'm still sitting there, and I haven't eaten my peas. So thinking that I was brilliant, I took my peas after a couple of hours, and I would start to line them up underneath my plate, thinking, oh, look, now they'll come and they'll see I've eaten my peas and they will release me from this pea prison. Well, they came along and of course, oh, honey, you're so good. I'm so proud of you. You ate your peas. And I'm just smiling at them. Then they go to lift my plate to take it to the kitchen and boom, I'm busted. There's my peas lined up in a perfect circle around my plate. I hated peas. Now, why is that important? Because a lot of times people put the P's off till the end of the day and they never get it done. P's are the things you don't want to do, the things that are laborsome. You know, a lot of people, that's working out. You don't want to do it. Well, get it done first in your day. You will feel so much better feeling like, you know, I got the worst of my day over, and now I've got the best of my day to look forward to. So eat your peas first, whatever that happens to be. Now you'll see right there on the blog, you're going to be able to see that we've got there, what is the description of this time management hack and what is the strategy? Well, the strategy for this one is just get it out of the way as quickly as possible. Well, let's take a look at number two. Number two is to avoid the black hole. Now, what is the black hole? The black hole is the time wasters in life. It's the things that you spend mindless time on, but it's making you no money. Now, if you followed my blog series, MMA, you guys know I'm a black belt in karate and I love mixed martial arts, but that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about money-making activities. You want to spend the majority of your time in money-making activities. Those are the activities that are bringing value to your life. Mindless scrolling on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, that's not making you money, that is a time waster. We call that the black hole. We call them not important and not urgent, right? When we look at the time management chart, not important, not urgent are time wasters. They consume valuable time. They consume valuable energy. Maybe for you, it's watching sports. I mean, is that sports team really making you money? I understand it's enjoyable, but you've got to look at your day. What matters most to you? Is it whether or not that team wins, or is it whether or not your family gets fed? Think about the time that you spend on reality TV. All of those items, endless emails that are just junk emails that you're reading through, they seem little. They take up a minute here, couple minutes there, but truthfully, they're adding up to hours. You should spend no more than 30 minutes in the black hole. 30 minutes maximum in your day. Now think about your day. Think about how much time you actually spend doing those things. Okay, let's take a look at number three. Now, number three are the not important but urgent things in your life. These are the things that are like interruptions, things that come and maybe it's not important to you, but it's important to someone else. Your boss comes into the office and says, you got to get this done now. Or the kids come up, mom, I've got to get some pantyhose for my speech and debate tournament. You know, they're not important to you at that moment, but they're urgent to someone else. This is when you're letting someone else or other people or other agendas run your life. These are the things you want to delegate. They're not things that demand you, but they seem to demand other people's urgency. So you want to make sure that you only give that about an hour of your time a day, because these are not important to your MMA, money-making activities, but they're urgent to someone else, okay? Number three is you want to manage crisis. Now, when we look at crisis, crisis is important and urgent. So what would that be like? Well, that would be like a family emergency. That would be like a deadline that pops up and you gotta get it done. It's important and it's urgent. It's having something that comes up in your life that says, I gotta get it done now, and you really do. Now these are the things, you just gotta get them done. You gotta get them done, but you need to get them done fast. Now here's the way, these are very, very important things. This is an important quadrant of your day. But here's what's important about these. These are things, if you managed your time better, you wouldn't have so many important, urgent things pop up. And that's why the next quadrant, quadrant number five, is very, very important. Or number five, quadrant four, is very, very important. This is the important, non-urgent. Okay, they're important to you, but they're not urgent. And why are they not urgent? These are the most important things in your life. This is the quadrant you want to live your life in. And here's how you do it. You want to do the things that are most important to you. Those are called core values. The things that matter most to you, and hopefully the things that matter most to God. They're important, but they're not urgent. Why are they not urgent? Because you've planned for them. You've made a point that you plan your day according to the things that matter most. So it's called time orderment. It's called being intentional with every minute. It's called Making Moments Matter. You guys will see some of my posts there on my official page that I'm always talking about time. Make the most of your time. You know, somebody once said, they saw a post of mine, I was out deep sea fishing. And if you've ever been deep sea fishing, you know that you're not always catching. There's a lot of wait time. So you're on the boat, and of course, you know, you got time for meditation, you got music playing. But what are you gonna do with those moments when the fish aren't just zzz on your line, right? Make moments matter. That's where I pick up a good book and I'll begin to invest in myself. That's where I'll spend time planning that day with my husband, a lot of things that we wanted to have accomplished in our life. Don't just waste moments, make moments matter. When you're at a stoplight, what are you doing at that stoplight? Are you strategizing for your day? Are you thinking about what you can be doing better? Are you listening to Automobile University, investing in yourself with a good Zig Ziglar or Staci Wallace podcast? What are you doing to make matters most? Well, when you plan for this fourth quadrant, when you are planning for peace, guess what's happening? You're planning a core values life. So let's just say, for example, you know that the speech and debate tournament is coming up for the kids. You're planning, making sure their clothes are all in order, making sure they've got their speeches in order. If you know you got a big baseball game this weekend with the kids, you know what? You're planning, making sure they got their gear together, making sure you've got food ready, making sure you've gone to the grocery store. Now, let's take it to a business level. Let's say you're wanting to get the next rank in your business. Well, you've got a plan, exactly what you want to do, and you've got 90 days to do it. Well, within 90 days, you can be planning. That's what we're going to talk about next when we're talking about chunking your goals. We're going to talk about planning so that you can live in the peace zone. Because what happens when you wait to the very last minute? Stress, chaos, disorder. You're not getting to work out anymore. You're not eating healthy. That is when sickness, disease, stress, heart disease hit people because they've not learned how to plan for peace. Now, the key to this zone is pacing. Pacing equals peace. Well, what is pacing? It's strategizing how much time you're going to need in order to accomplish those core values in your life. So let's look at number six. Six is very important to help you plan for peace, and it's called chunking your goals. Now, there's a download on this blog where we're actually giving you a free insert. This is going to be a major portion of the Shift Happens Life Mastery course. And this is where we're going to teach you how to chunk your goals, how to take a big goal and boil it down into a bite-sized morsel so you go from, here's what I want to accomplish this year, to knowing what do I need to do every single day in order for that to happen. So let's just take a look at it this way. Let's say you're wanting to lose 80 pounds this year. And so we're gonna break it down into four quarters, just like a corporation would. What are your first quarter goals, second quarter goals, third and fourth? Now a quarter, breaking out 12 months into quarters, means 3 months or 90 days per quarter. So your first 90 days of the year, you're gonna look and go, okay, well, what are my quarterly goals? Well, if you wanna lose 80 pounds in 12 months, your quarterly goals would be divided by four. So now you would need to lose 20 pounds first 90 days, 20 pounds the second 90 days, third and fourth, and you'd hit your 80 pound goal. Does that make sense? So if you happen to lose 28 pounds, you can adjust the rest of your, or if you happen to only hit 15, you're gonna have to adjust the rest of your year. Now, you take it from quarterly goals, and then you're going to do a divisible and get it down into your monthly goals. And then you're going to take your monthly goals, and this is what the download on this blog gives you. It's going to take you down to weekly goals. Well, once you get it into weekly goals, guess where you go next? Down to your daily action list. You can know exactly what you need to do every single day, how much on average weight you need to lose per day so that you can accomplish that yearly goal. Again, planning for peace. This is called pacing. How you pace will result in peace because you're gonna get closer to your goals as opposed to just randomly working out, hoping that you hit the marker, getting to the end of the year and going, I'm so far behind, I wish I had. Versus what these seven time management hacks are gonna do for you, instead of saying, I wish I had, you're gonna start living in the I'm glad I did zone. You'll get to the end of the year and go, I'm glad I did. Use that course to really strategize my time and be intentional with every single moment. So use these downloads that are on this blog to help you make your yearly goals, your quarterly goals, your monthly goals, your weekly goals, all the way down to your daily action plans. Now, the final thing, and probably the most important, is dream big, work hard, sleep often. Dream big. Now, what is that? I want you to set big goals. I want you to be number one in your company. I want you to go for that promotion. I want you to be able to leave an imprint on the world. I want to be able to see us getting comments of people who says, you know what, I applied this and I am making a difference in the world. I want to see, you know, my mission mandate actually is, I am a warrior sent to awaken sleeping warriors to step into their divine mandate and advance the kingdom of God. I believe there's a call and a purpose on your life, and that's why these types of time management hacks are important, so that you can do everything God's created you to do on this planet. Now, here's what's exciting about this. When you dream big, I really believe that big, hairy, impossible, audacious goals are just you saying, I believe God can. That's you believing beyond the possible, the impossible. Believing that you're going to break records, do things that other people have never done before. God honors bold prayers. He honors bold and audacious goals, because you're putting him in a capability of saying, you know what, on my own, I can't do this. But with you, all things are possible. So have big dreams, big goals. Have world-changing, history-making objectives in your life. But here's the next thing, is work hard. You know, there's nobody that I know of that's a seven-figure, eight-figure, world-changer, history maker that is getting up every day, watching TV, scrolling through Facebook, just kind of hanging out, hoping life happens. No, those are the people who are intentional with their time. They're working smarter instead of harder. They've learned how to put systems in place so they can do more in a short amount of time of what would take most people literally hours and hours and hours to do. Right now, even while I'm shooting this video, I've got autoresponder systems. I've got follow-up systems. I've got online marketing systems that are working for me. I build not only traditional businesses, but I also build residual income, because I want to make the most of my time and I want to make the most of my money. My investments are working on my behalf right now. You want to start thinking, that's what we call warrior DNA. Challenge you again, tap into those live warrior DNA Facebook posts that we have at facebook.com/StaciWallaceOfficial. The reason why it's important is always keep your mindset moving forward with a CEO mentality, as if this is a massive billion-dollar corporation that you're running, and it's up to you to make it happen. You've got to make the most of your time. So dream big, work hard, but here's the other thing, sleep often. Now, I've got a lot of CEOs, epic serial entrepreneurs, who think they can escape this one. And this is the one where I care more about you than I do about how much money you make, right? I care that your family is healthy. I care that your life is healthy. I care that your spirituality is healthy. And the only way you're going to be able to maintain that is understand the power of rest. Even God himself, in 7 days, he worked 6 days, bam, 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 bam. And on the seventh day, he rested. Now, if God, the creator of the universe, omnipresent, omniscient, omnipotent, had to take the rest, don't you think it's important? That's even more than 10% rest. Well, think about it. You want to make sure that you're getting adequate rest, not only every single day, which is 6 to 8 hours a day. You know, all my studies of neuroplasticity and neuroscience and psychology and brain health, I have learned, even with the weight loss programs, the ultimate body makeover that we wrote, all of those things that show how the body works systemically, neurologically, you can think you're outpacing sleep. I don't need it. I can sleep on 4 hours. No, you can't. Even those who claim they can, I've watched it. It affects their family. It affects their sex life. It affects their libido. It affects their finances. It affects their kids. You have got to know that you've got to get rest. So when we're talking about seven time management hacks, you just need to strategize every day. Don't let anyone's urgency or crisis take away from your 6 to 8 hours of sleep, so you can be cognitively healthy, creative, alert, able to make good decisions, and most of all, have a great attitude for everyone around you so that they actually like doing life with you. So these are the 7 time management hacks that I think every single leader needs to have. I want to encourage you. All of this is based around having a core values-driven life. When we come out later on this year with the Shift Happens Life Mastery course, I want to make sure that your voice is heard as well. So please, if this has helped you in any way, comment below. Let us hear your thoughts. Let us hear what other topics you really want to hear, sound wisdom and proven principles so that you can live the life that God truly created you to live. Remember, now is the time. This is the place. You are the one that's going to help us make life better for many. Have warrior DNA. Follow me on Facebook at Staci Wallace Official, and I look forward to seeing you on the other side and in the next blog post. God bless everyone.